Hello friends. Welcome to this channel. In this video, we will overview the topic, hemolytic uremic syndrome. So let's begin. Hemolytic uremic syndrome is a primary thrombotic microangiopathy. But what is thrombotic microangiopathy? As the name indicate, due to some reason, there is a pathology in the microvessels such as capillaries and arterioles. This leads to the activation of thrombosis. Platelets decreases due to consumption, leading to thrombocytopenia. Red blood cells, while passing through abnormal vessels, are destroyed. This is called microangiopathic hemolytic anemia. As a result, besides anemia, other features of hemolysis will be present, including unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia, reticulocytosis, increased LDH, and reduced haptoglobin. On peripheral film, fragmented RBCs or schistocytes will be found. Further features of thrombotic microangiopathy depends on the organ affected by microangiopathy. Thrombotic microangiopathies are broadly categorized as primary thrombotic microangiopathies and thrombotic microangiopathies associated with systemic disorders. Primary thrombotic microangiopathies have two diseases included in it. One is hemolytic uremic syndrome, and other is thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura, or TTP. For TTP, please watch our video. The link is given in description below, and you can also access through clicking the link in right upper corner of the screen. Systemic disorders causing thrombotic microangiopathies include DIC, malignancy, systemic sclerosis, malignant hypertension, preeclampsia, and HELLP syndrome. And now, coming back to our main topic, hemolytic uremic syndrome. Now you know that hemolytic uremic syndrome is a primary thrombotic microangiopathy. HUS predominantly affects the renal microcirculation, and so, along with thrombocytopenia and hemolytic anemia, you will get renal impairment. Causes. The causes of HUS can be categorized into Shiga toxin-associated and non-Shiga toxin-associated hemolytic uremic syndrome. Shiga toxin-associated HUS is also called typical hemolytic uremic syndrome because it is the more common form, accounting for 90-95% cases. And by this convention, non-Shiga toxin-associated hemolytic uremic syndrome is also known as atypical hemolytic uremic syndrome. Shiga toxin-associated hemolytic uremic syndrome is caused by infection with organisms that produce enterotoxins called Shiga-like toxin or verotoxins. In developing countries, this commonly occurs with Shigella dysentery-associated diarrhea. While in developed countries, this is more common due to infection with enterohemorrhagic E. coli. The E. coli serotype O157H7 is the best known, but other serotypes that produce verotoxins may also be responsible. Although these bacteria live as commensals in the gut of cattle and other livestock, they can cause hemorrhagic diarrhea in humans when the infection is contracted from contaminated food products, water, or other infected individuals. In a proportion of infected cases, verotoxin produced by the organisms enters the circulation and binds to specific glycolipid receptors that are expressed on the surface of microvascular endothelial cells. Most cases are sporadic, but large outbreaks related to poor sanitation may occur. This form of HUS is more common in children, and the affected HUS patient will have history of bloody diarrhea. Recovery is good in most patients with this form of HUS. Treatment is mostly supportive. But sometimes, renal replacement therapy may be required for up to 14 days. No other specific treatments have been shown to accelerate renal recovery. Atypical or non-Shiga-associated HUS is not associated with infection, and there will be no history of diarrhea. Rather, it is a complement-mediated thrombotic microangiopathy. It is either familial or occur as sporadic cases. The familial form is associated with genetic abnormalities of the complement regulatory proteins. Various triggers for sporadic non-Shiga toxin, HUS, have been identified, including non-enteric infections, viruses, drugs, malignancies, transplantation, pregnancy, and in rare cases, other underlying medical conditions like antiphospholipid syndrome and SLE. In atypical HUS, in addition to supportive care including renal replacement therapy if necessary, management of complement-mediated hemolytic uremic syndrome includes plasma exchange to replace complement component and remove pathogenic autoantibodies. Recently, impressive results have been reported with the anti-C5 monoclonal antibody, eculizumab. It binds to C5, thereby preventing activation of the terminal complement cascade. And this is it for this video. Thanks for watching. Provide your feedback and comments. Like this video, share with other colleagues, and consider subscribing to this channel to get notifications about latest videos.